Hello viewers, a warm welcome to all of you. In this section of the digital communication, we are going to discuss another very interesting topic, that is quadrature phase shift keying or QPSK. This is totally conducted by Ganon, powered by Wishback. I am your mentor, Professor Aritra De. So, in quadrature phase shift keying or QPSK, a high frequency signal is used as a carrier. You are already familiar with the term carrier. There are four phase shift for 00, 10, 01, and for 11. Now, let us discuss the QPSK consisting symbol. QPSK may consist of the symbol S100, symbol S201, symbol S310, and symbol S411. But in this case, two symbols or two information are transmitted simultaneously. Hence, the symbol rate is capital T suffix S is equal to TB plus TB for two symbols is equal to 2TB, where TB is the bit duration. The phase of QPSK is 0 degree for 00. It is 90 degree for 01. It is 180 degree for 10. What is the case for 11? Guess? Okay. It is 270 degree. The phase for 00 is angle 0 as shown in the figure. The phase for 01 is angle 90 as shown in the figure. The phase for 10 is angle 180 as shown in the display. The phase for 11, as we discussed earlier, is 270 degree, as you can see in this figure. A QPSK signal can be mathematically represented by capital V suffix QPSK T is equal to root 2 PS cos omega CT plus 2M plus 1 into pi by 4 bracket close, where M is 0, 1, 2, 3 and PS is the power of the symbol. Now, by substitute M equal to 0, it will become VQPSK is equal to root 2 PS cos omega CT plus pi by 4, which is symbol S1. Now by substitute M equal to 1, it will become VQPSK T is equal to root 2 PS cos omega CT plus 3 pi by 4, which is S2. Now by substitute M equal to 2, it will become VQPSK T is equal to root 2 PS cos omega CT plus 5 pi by 4, which is S3. Lastly, by substituting M equal to 3, it will become VQPSK is equal to root 2 PS cos omega CT plus 7 pi by 4, which is symbol S4. Now let us discuss the transmitter or the modulator of the QPSK. The QPSK modulator uses a bit splitter to multiply with local oscillator, a 2-bit serial to parallel converter, and a summer circuit. Following is a block diagram for the same. At the modulator's input, the message signal 7 bit, that is 2nd bit, 4th bit, 6th bit, etc., and odd bits, that mean 1st bit, 3rd bit and 5th bit, etc., are separated by the bit splitter. And then they are multiplied with the same carrier to generate odd BPSK, which is nothing but a called PSKI, and even BPSK called PSKQ. The PSKQ signal is anyhow phase shifted by 90 degree before being modulated. Now let us discuss the demodulation section of the QPSK. The two product detectors at the input of demodulator simultaneously demodulate two BPSK signals. The pair of bits are recovered here from the original data. These signals, after processing, are passed to the parallel to serial converter. Now let us discuss spectrum representation of the QPSK. The bandwidth of the original message signal is FB by 2. The modulated signal bandwidth is also FB by 2. Now discuss the advantage of QPSK. QPSK provide very good noise immunity. It provides low error probability. The bandwidth in QPSK is twice efficient is compared to BPSK modulation. For the same bit error rate or BER, the bandwidth required by QPSK is reduced to half as compared to BPSK. It is advantageous, isn't it? It is more efficient utilization of the available bandwidth of the transmission channel, right? And lastly, the carrier power almost remain constant because of OQPSK amplitude is not much. Now, obviously, every product or every system have some disadvantage. Now, let us discuss the disadvantage of QPSK. QPSK is not more power efficient modulation technique compared to other modulation type, as more power is required to transmit two bits. QPSK is more complex compared to BPSK receiver due to four state needed to recover of the binary data information. Now let us discuss the comparison among BPSK and the QPSK. The number one comparison is variable parameter. In BPSK it is phase, in case of QPSK it is also phase. The modulation type in case of the BPSK is 2-level, in case of the QPSK, it is 4-level. The presentation type in case of BPSK is single binary bit is presented by one phase state. But in case of QPSK, a group of two binary bits is represented by one phase state. The bit rate in case of BPSK, bit rate is equal to baud rate. But in case of QPSK, bit rate is twice the baud rate. The detection method in case of BPSK is coherent. In case of QPSK, it is also coherent. The complexity, BPSK is obviously complex, but in case of the QPSK, it is very complex. The application of the BPSK is suitable for high bit rate, but for the QPSK, it is suitable for very high bit rate. Now let us discuss QPSK modulation application. Similar to BPSK, QPSK is used in various cellular wireless standards such as GSM, CDMA, LTE, 802.11 WLAN, 802.16 fixed and mobile, WiMAX, satellite and cable TV. Number two application is, as difference between any two constellation point is 90 degrees maximum, QPSK modulation type has many benefits. It is robust compared to the other modulation technique except BPSK. And number three is, it has double data rate carrying capacity compared to BPSK, as two bits are mapped on each constellation point. In BPSK, only one bit is mapped to each constellation point. Now let us discuss a comparison between the OQPSK and QPSK. The difference between the OQPSK and the QPSK is, in case of OQPSK, there is offset between even and odd bit. But in QPSK, there is no offset between even and odd bit. In case of OQPSK, odd and even bit will never change simultaneously. But in case of QPSK, odd and even bit can change simultaneously. In case of OQPSK, maximum phase change in the output signal is 90 degrees, that is pi by 2. But in case of QPSK, maximum phase shift is 180 degree or pi. In case of OQPSK, amplitude variation at the instant of abrupt phase changes आर ऑफ सिमिलर एम्पलीट्यूड एज कंपेयर टू क्यूपीएस के. इन क्यूपीएस के एम्पलीट्यूड वेरिएशन एट द इंस्टेंट ऑफ एब्रप्ट फेस चेंजेस आर ऑफ लार्जर एम्पलीट्यूड एज कंपेयर टू ओक्यूपीएस. सो व्हाट वी हैव डिस्कस टूडे, वी डिस्कस टूडे क्यूपीएस के बेसिक कॉन्सेप्ट. Then we discussed phase changes of QPSK. After that we discussed transmitter and the receiver of the QPSK. Then we discussed the bandwidth of the QPSK. After that we discussed advantage and the disadvantage of the QPSK and application of the QPSK. And lastly we discussed comparison of other modulation technique with QPSK. That's all for this segment. Practice QPSK transmitter, receiver and all the section repeatedly and stay tuned to Ganon. Thank you viewers. Bye.